CADLink for Epicor. CADLink is a premier CAD to ERP integration tool for Epicor. It is a bidirectional tool used to create, compare, and modify bill of materials and part data at the click of a button. CADLink is developed by QBuild Software, an Epicor partner. By using CADLink, you can eliminate clerical work and increase utilization of your skilled engineers. By synchronizing your bill of materials and part data with your CAD data, you will reduce errors and inaccuracies and prevent unnecessary losses from scrap parts, shop floor confusions, and inventory errors. Here we have a multi-level assembly open with SolidWorks. Let's imagine that you are an engineer that has just finished designing this and ready to enter it into Epicor. Because CADLink is directly integrated in SolidWorks, we can launch directly from this interface. Now, CADLink is comparing all of the components and their properties, such as part number, description, and quantity in the model we just created, with the matching bill of materials in Epicor. The results of this comparison are shown in this grid. As you can see, CADLink has maintained the multi-level assembly structure. The colors highlight the differences between this assembly and the item master. Let's talk about these different colors. White rows represent parts from your model that already exist in your item master. Lines in green represent parts that exist in your model but not in your item master. CADLink will create this part in your item master with the appropriate part number, revision, description, quantity, and it will be added to the bill of materials for you. Rows in gray represent parts to be removed from the bill of materials because they do not exist in the CAD model. CADLink will remove this part from the bill of materials to synchronize it with your model. In addition, items may be added to the bill of materials by right-clicking on the gray square and selecting Add Manual Part. Manual parts are parts that will exist in the bill of materials but not in the CAD side. Examples for this may include items such as paint, glue, tape, or many others. So CADLink can search directly into your Epicor database using the part number and description and add these parts to the bill of materials. So, for example, if I want to add a bolt, I can do a search into my Epicor database to find the appropriate bolt and easily add it to the bill of materials. And finally, fields in yellow represent discrepancies between your CAD and ERP data. So, by right-clicking on this field, we can see what the CAD description is and what the Epicor description is, and select whichever is correct. Or, we can also manually enter our own. When CADLink saves, it will push this field bidirectionally to update both the CAD model and the bill of materials on the Epicor side. CADLink also has several Epicor fields, such as the product group, part class, and part type. Any drop-down menus in Epicor will be reflected here. In addition, CADLink also has support for raw materials. So, if a component has raw materials, you can once again search directly into Epicor and easily add raw material information. So, if this part is made of steel, for example, I can do a quick search to select the appropriate raw material and easily add it to the bill of materials. Operations can also be assigned to manufactured parts through the CADLink interface. You can easily add operation templates from existing Epicor parts. After doing so, we can go back to the bill of materials grid and dictate which work center parts are to be consumed at. We have a few tabs remaining, but these are ease of use and review tabs. BOM changes tab will list all of the changes that will take place when CADLink saves. This helps you keep track of what exactly CADLink is changing in Epicor and on the CAD side, and review any changes before saving. This is a read-only tab. Keep in mind, none of these changes have actually occurred yet. CADLink has not saved, but these changes will occur when CADLink does save. This tab can also be exported as a PDF for your convenience. In addition to the Changes tab, we also have the Impact tab, which shows the manufacturing impact. This data is pulled from Epicor. In this section, CADLink displays inventory, purchase orders, job orders, where the part is used, and cost summary. The CAD Properties tab is a read-only tab which allows you to view the properties of your CAD model. This makes it easier for the engineer to view their CAD data without switching back and forth between CADLink and SolidWorks or another CAD system. Finally, the Messages tab will list all the messages that need to be addressed before CADLink can save. For example, if we only partially fill out an operation, CADLink will generate error messages in accordance with Epicor's rules. By double-clicking one of these messages, it will take us to the offending line, highlighting it. Please note that while CADLink displays error messages, the Save button is actually grayed out. As you address the Messages tab, the messages will disappear and the Save button will be re-enabled. This means the data is now ready to save into Epicor. As you can see, the Save button is now re-enabled. CADLink is a powerful tool to equip to your engineers. The time engineers save by using CADLink can be put back into doing actual engineering work. Thank you for watching.